The crew departs from Ningbo for the Zhoushan Islands. Central High Street has a vintage air, tracing history across the Zhoushan Islands. The crew takes in the murals on stone houses and dines on yellow croakers. The ocean scenery here is truly marvelous. You're watching the series Along the Coast. These islands are all under the administration of Zhoushan, which lies in the East China Sea to the south of the Yangtze River estuary and outside Hangzhou Bay. It's bordered by the cities of Shanghai, Hangzhou, and Ningbo. Here, the water that flows between the many islands are their streets, and the local people make good use of their unique, rich resource. For example, they've developed Phoenix Island into a resort with a five-star hotel.
舟山呢，目前有人居住的岛屿啊，是100零几个，而这里的人口呢，是100来万，也就是说，100来万人口居住在100多个岛屿上，这是一种什么样的概念？在接下来的拍摄当中，我们还将近距离的更多的去了解这样一座与海密不可分的城市——舟山。
In the old days, the only means of transportation between the islands was by boat. But when the weather was bad, the waters would be quite choppy, and communication between the islanders and the mainland would be cut. But in 1999, the construction of 5 cross-sea bridges in Zhoushan began, and they were opened to traffic in 2009. The 5 bridges have also accelerated economic development in Zhoushan. It's now a fashionable and youthful city with wide roads, neat green areas, and high buildings. People began to move to the Zhoushan Islands during the Neolithic Age more than 5,000 years ago. Around 2,000 years ago, the central government set up the administration of Dinghai County in Zhoushan during the spring and autumn period.
每一个城市总会有几条街道、几座建筑，见证着城市的变化发展。那在舟山呢，它就是中大街。这条中大街啊，它已经有着300多年的历史了。过去这里是舟山最繁华、最热闹的一条商业街。如今呢，这条街道古韵犹存，保留着这座城市的古老记忆。
Central High Street developed from the late Ming Dynasty to the early Qing Dynasty, and some of the original buildings have been preserved. This street, little more than 200 meters long, was once lined with stores doing brisk business. Despite several renovations, the street has retained some of its original look and feel.
啊，住了多少年了？嗯，这是50多年。50多年，
里边还挺深的啊。
The woman takes the reporter to the second floor. The stairway is very narrow. There's a vintage lamp in the stairwell. Mrs. Lu's room is spartanly decorated. Her children live elsewhere, but they come to visit her when they can.
90岁，
哎，就是
哇，你真看不出来，精神真好。
就是。
那就是看着这个街的变化发展了。
哎，这个我连鸡肉我给你喂大好，嗯，又好喂巧。
哎，没想到这个阳台这么窄。
When a renovation project was carried out on the street 2 years ago, the local government instructed the workers to retain the old look of the street. Mrs. Lewis says that this is the reason she and her neighbors love where they live.
坐在这儿舒不舒服？
哎，舒服，凳子蛮舒服哈。阿拉年纪大人了，干嘛个凳子好？假设当公安瞧，蛮乖龙噶，就用阳台来加加了。
Mrs. Lur loves to stand on her narrow balcony to chat with the neighbors or just to observe life. The old houses stand in neat rows and most of the windows are propped open. In the street, some women are cleaning fish. It seems as if life here has remained pretty much unchanged for the past 300 years.
每隔一段，你看这儿有这样一面墙，再往前不远的地方也有这样一面墙。这个呢，当地的居民告诉我呀，这是防火墙，因为整条街都是这种木质结构的建筑，所以呢，就每隔一段建起这样一座墙，万一是就发生了火灾的话，在这个地方就可以终止，就不至于整条街都受到牵连。
In the late 1800s, there was a disastrous fire in Dinghai, and it leveled the entire street. Afterwards, the local residents pooled money to build these firewalls. As well as the old residences, there are also many shops on the street.
Here is a Ruihe 老字号，还挂着饼糕。我想应该是做糕点的吧，这么香。奶奶您好，
哦，你好，
哟，你看烤箱就在这个地方，我已经闻到香味了。是刚刚，这是刚刚都烤好的吗？
不过烤好，它热的。
热的是那边是就都是这种糕点是吧？
对呀，都是老式糕点。
啊，这是什么呀？
这个书名叫菊红糕。
什么糕？
橘
子糕。
啊，橘红糕，红红的红。
哦，橘红糕。
我们别名叫十字糕。
很软很糯的那种感觉，而且你仔细吃的话，有一点点橘子的味道。
The pastries sold at Ruihe Bakery are very famous. There's often a long queue of customers at its door. Several generations have lived in this place. Many of the pastry items sold here are new to the crew, as most are Zhoushan specialties.
开店开多久了？
我老头七十岁了，老头的七十岁的爷爷，你算算看多少年了？
老，您，
我老头七十岁
了，
我
也七十岁了，
老潘的爷爷多少年？
盘了三代的一个店，
对，坐这里看呀，
难怪叫做那个百年老店了。
小时候的味道，老味道，
温温的，
温温的，刚刚做好，
不一样。这个会后面正
现在做，
我们能进去看看吗？
去看呀。
This couple makes all the pastries. The kitchen is small. At the moment, the man and his apprentice are busy making some sesame cakes.
这么大一块啊？
这么大一块
就
要切开的。
就是这个软软的，现在还是软的是吧？趁软的，然后把这一块切先切成条，然后再把它按压成这个这么漂亮的是吧？我刚才听奶奶说，就是这个店是从您的爷爷传下来的。
对。
那是什么哪一年的事儿了？
清朝。
清朝的时候。
啊，清朝。
那个时候也是这样一个店吗？就跟现在。
那还没有哎，都发芽糖了。
After the Ruihe Bakery was opened during the Qing Dynasty, it became famous for its malt sugar. Over time, they've increased the variety of their offerings, but they've never toyed with the traditional recipes.
最热闹的就是这儿，
最热闹就是这儿，最有钱的也是这儿。
This couple has lived here for a long time, witnessing the changes taking place from the small window.Many new stores have opened and many old ones have disappeared, but they say that their store will remain so that their loyal customers can continue to enjoy their products. Many stores specialized in ocean-related items are also in the street. Among their goods for sale are model boats, shell carvings and drawings detailing the life of fishing families. There's also a cafe where you can sip a cup of freshly ground coffee and people watch.
真的没有想到这样一条街有特别古朴的老房子，有住在这里的老人，同时呢也有这些很新潮的小店，让从男女老少，从年轻人到老人，都可以在这条街上找到属于自己的记忆和想停留的地方。
The performers of the flea dance give a comedic performance. The crew searches for the secrets hidden in stone houses by the sea. The seriesAlong the coast continues. The crew is about to leave Central High Street when they notice a beautiful sculpture at its entrance. The inscription mentions something called the flea dance.
这个雕塑呢是在中大街非常有名的展现舟山的跳蚤舞的一个雕塑。那这个跳蚤舞也有很多年的历史了，现在在定海的城区还有很多人会跳这种舞蹈，那我们也去城区里看一看究竟是什么样的舞蹈，这样的动作又叫做跳蚤舞呢？
The flea dance became popular in Dinghai in the Qing Dynasty. In 1922, a teacher named Zhang Xiaoshan, a native of Dinghai, choreographed this dance based on the story Master Ji fighting against the god of fire. And this made the flea dance even more popular.
Is
you seen or heard? I played it. I helped them play the flute.
哦，您是参吹唢呐？
啊，我给他们吹唢呐，吹了好几年了。
A local resident says that the flea dancers will rehearse today, so the crew decides to go over and have a look. Many local residents have already shown up to watch.
这是一个院子，然后周围全是这样的老房子，现在是。表演的那有年轻人，而且往那边看还有好小的小朋友啊，一个是化妆成济公的样子。
The crew didn't expect such a lively scene. The acting of the children is especially funny. It's a couple's dance. The man dances in a measured gait with his toes pointing outwards in a half squat. The woman dances as if to escape the man's reach.The loud noise of the gongs and drums adds to the cheery mood, and every dancer wears a comic expression. One spectator says it's known as the flea dance because the dancers' movements are like jumping fleas.
你扮演的是这个济公，
是济公。
你呢？
火神，
火神，火神。
对。
然后两个人这样对着表演，好像都是这样一对一对的，是吧？
对。
你跳的是谁？你知道吗？
知道。
是谁呀？
济公。
谁教你们的？
陈老师。
陈老师。
嗯。
谁是陈老师？哦，原来这就是刚才那个在旁边敲锣的那个老师，是。都是您教他们，这全都是
是的，这大大小小都应该说是我教出来的徒弟，大徒弟、小徒弟都是的。
Ms. Chung and her elder brother learned the flea dance from her Zhifu, a veteran flea dancer. After he passed away, Ms. Chung and her brother began to teach the flea dance.
现在是跳蚤的蚤，
因为它的动作
是
的。
炉灶的灶，
哎，跳灶，
哎，因为是腊月二十三祭灶的时候，
我们在灶神爷面前跳的，
所以你这个头上画的这个就代表的是，
哎，对，是的，火，
包括道具，
哦、
Many kindergartens in Baichuan teach the flea dance, and that's where these kids learned it. Mrs. Chung and her brother say they hope that this special form of folk dance can be preserved forever.
现在拜的最小的两个小老师，一个小男孩，一个小女孩，几岁了？
我们两个都是女的。啊！
是小小女孩啊！那你教一下姐姐吧，好不好？刚才姐姐这个动作做的对不对？
不对，那要怎么样才对啊？
要把脖子往前伸。
往前伸，这样，这样对不对？对吧？
再把手往前。
手要往前。你喊预备起，然后我们一起做好不好？好不好？好。
一二三，预备起。
The Outens' love by so many children for the flea dance here testifies to the enduring vitality of this unique form of folk art. There are more than 10 flea dance teams here, and they're often invited to perform abroad. As Ms. Chung mentioned, young people these days have fewer and fewer chances to connect with the folk arts, so children should be given more chances to learn about them so they can keep it alive for future generations to enjoy.
这个地方一种文化生活的体现，看到这么热闹的跳蚤舞，也能够想到以前这里的庙会一定很热闹，这里可能在海边的生活一定也是非常的快乐，生活在这儿看着这种舞蹈就是一种幸福。
The stained walls, the old streets and the ancient houses in the old urban area of Dinghai have nurtured the local folk art.Each of the 1,390 plus islands of Zhoushan is unique, so the crew heads to another island by boat.
Zhoushan 分为两区两县，结束了定海区的行程，我们现在要前往的是胜寺县。那交通工具呢，就是我身后的这艘船了，出发吧。
Zhoushan is in the middle of a busy shipping lane.The ships stir up the silt, make the water muddy. It takes 2 hours for the crew to reach Banglong Island in Shangsi County.
We usually see this Huanglong Island, and you can see that on the shore, there are some fish piled up. And here, it seems like there are boats being traded. Hey, are these fish sold? Yes, sold. How much are they? 7块一斤，小点儿的呢？
小的五块。
小的五块啊？
六块。
哦，这都是刚捞上来的吗？就这个船吗？
Local residents say that fishing boats come to the island every day, and that the fishermen sell their catch on the dock. The village radio station announces the day's catch, and those villagers who want to buy fish head to the docks to buy them. And the price is pretty cheap.
海鲶鱼，
这跟我平时看到的鲶鱼很不一样，它怎么是透明的呀？
啊，2块钱一斤
啊，这么便宜啊
！The crew heads towards Jir Alshir Village on Huanglong Island. A large stretch of stone houses appears off in the distance, and a long flight of stone steps leading up the hill is flanked by these stone houses.The stone blocks are closely sealed together with only a little cement. The crew hooks up with Wang Kwei Kwei, who will show them around the village.
I found that his house seems to be all the house itself is built more tightly, and the outside of the circle of walls is a little bit looser, maybe to save some material. Yes, yes. And also to save some material. Yes. And
here, you see, there's no water.
直接垒上去，中间就塞一点小的石块，但是还挺紧的。
对呀、啊，结实啊，这个
特别结实，都没法抽出一块。
Mr. Wang explains that the villagers built stone houses because they live by the sea. The stone houses are strong enough to withstand a hit from a typhoon, and they're not easily eroded by seawater or the saline air.These houses, built 30 to 40 years ago, are still very solid. The raw material is granite, which has a dense structure and is very hard, although it is easy to chip it into various shapes and sizes.
Hi, Anna. 生活就很简单，就是在这样，可能自家门口的台阶上，然后或者是门口，就大家坐在一起晒着太阳聊着天儿，
是的，
每天都这样是吧？天气好的时候，
是的，
嗯，挺幸福的，
哎，幸福的，这里女人挺幸福的，
Most men in the village support their families by fishing, while their wives do all the household chores. The crew often sees villagers carrying their catch in the street or cleaning fish in their courtyards. The village has just over 2,000 residents. Mr. Wan takes them to the home of Mr. Wu to take a look.
比如说一条沟下来，这个一条沟里边都是石头。
把它弄过来，凿成这样，
是
吧？
All the granite used for building houses was quarried from nearby hills. They were formed into stone bricks. The first stone house was built near the dock for storing fish caught at sea. And it was after that that the villagers discovered that this kind of house could withstand typhoons and earthquakes, and it was also moisture proof. Gradually, more and more stone houses began appearing in the village. Mr. Wu says it's not easy to build a stone house. The fishermen pool their labor and money together to build each house. Through their own efforts, the villagers have built up a comfortable living environment for themselves. And thanks to the stone houses, the village has become a tourist attraction. Mr. Wang says the thing he's most proud of is how honest his fellow villagers are. They get along together very well, and many of them are related by blood. The stone houses are very close to each other, so neighbors can have a chat by the window or sit together to talk under the sun. The local residents are honest and they treat each other well. Mr. Wu doesn't do any fishing nowadays. He looks after his grandson at home instead. He insists on having the crew over for lunch, saying that the fish cooked by a fisherman's family is a unique experience. He takes them to a small market to load up on some ingredients for the meal. The several food stalls along the road are small, but they sell everything needed for cooking a meal. In the past, islanders rarely had fresh vegetables to eat, and they were much more expensive than fish. Now, though, there are more boats to transport them, and so the islanders have no difficulty in obtaining fresh vegetables. Mr. Wu is going to cook a traditional dish, fish stewed with pickled mustard greens. He puts the anglerfish, pickled mustard greens, and some salt in the pot to stew without any other spices.
这个鱼肉特别的嫩，一点刺都没有，就
这么大一块，你看。嗯。一点刺儿都没有。
嗯。
而且是因为这种煮的方法，还挺入味的，有这种咸菜的味儿进去。
嗯。
Mr. Wang and Mr. Wu sit and drink fish soup while chatting. It's easy to sense that the villagers are very satisfied with their simple life. Walking on the stone road again, the crew gets a sense of the attraction of this place. From up here, one can see boats approaching the harbor ready to offload their catch.
See you. 在这个小村庄呢逛了一整天，真的很喜欢这种感觉，就是用自己的脚步走遍小村庄的角角落落，感受这里最地道的渔家生活。这里的人们生活很简单，但是衣食住行都和海密不可分，而同时呢也有着渔家人的淳朴和热情。现在天色已经渐渐暗下来了，我们即将离开这个岛。那其实在舟山每一个岛都很有特色，都很不一样，我们去看看下一个岛吧。
The bold colors and imaginative subjects of these pictures were drawn by wives of fishermen on an island in the East China Sea. The yellow crocus cooked by a local family taste very tender and juicy. You're watching the series Along the Coast.
是菜园岛，这个岛上的渔村呢都是这样临海而建的，像我们身旁看到的这个东海渔村，你看它就距离这个海边不到200米。在天气暖和的时候，这样的渔村的渔家乐很有特色，就是乘坐这个海上我们看到的这些小船，跟着渔民一起出海捕鱼，然后回到渔民家住上一天。但是呢，现在真的由于天气太冷，不是体验渔家乐最好的季节。可是我们今天来到这个渔村啊，其实是要来看一看它更有特色的渔民画。这里的渔民画在整个舟山都非常的有名哦。
In Donghai Village, we see white two-storied houses arranged in neat little rows with signs that advertise inns and restaurants. More than 100 of the 300-odd families in the village now run inns and restaurants, primarily serving tourists. Tourists come to the village not only to enjoy the natural scenery, but also the murals drawn by the local women.
东海渔村的渔民画究竟特别在哪里呢？往这边看。走过了一排白墙的房子之后，现在看到的这一排房子啊，颜色特别的鲜艳，啊，每一面这个墙上都画满了各种各样的图案。那其实这些呢，就是渔民画了。你看这一幅就能够看得出来，这些密密麻麻的网格啊，它其实画的就是一张渔网，很大的章鱼。来到这个渔村啊，千万不要忘记的就是带上相机，因为这里的渔民画不需要你花钱买，只需要按下快门就可以把这一些渔民画收藏在你的相机里了。
Murals like these can be seen on the walls of over 100 houses in Donghai Village, so not surprisingly perhaps the villagers nicknamed Mural Village.The murals depict the daily lives of the local fishing families, and over 40 of them are found on the western side of the village. Many tourists come to the island just to see these murals, and more women in the village are learning how to paint them. The crew has arranged to stay in a fisherman's home. Mrs. Lean is the leader of the mural painters in the village.
两位是？
哎，是我们也是一个村子里的在画画，都是那我们游客画的。看着我们在画画，他也拿起笔来了，在墙上画了。
Mrs. Ling displays many of her paintings in the living room on the first floor of her house. She began to paint 10 years ago.
这一幅其实我已经复制过了，原作的是给那个韩国人来去。
世界各地的游客
都
有到这来住，
不管说国语，还要说世界语嘞。
英语你也会说？
英语不会说，想去学嘞。
Mrs. Lin explains that very few tourists come here in the winter, so this is when the women do most of their painting. They often come to her house for a get together.
就是，像这边啊，就是画这种画，有多少年的历史？
已经是二十几年了，二十几年了。
从八几年的时候，我们就开始画。嗯，丈夫都出去外面打鱼嘛，鱼嫂在家里面没事干嘛，就把那个鱼啊，然后渔船啊什么，把我们生活啊全部都画下来。然后刚开始的时候只是一两个人画，然后画的话大家都觉得都蛮好的，都蛮有趣的，大家一起画，然后越画越好，越来越多，越画越好的。
That is why most of the paintings done by women depict the daily lives of their families. When the fishermen's wives paint scenes from their husbands' work out at sea, they let their imaginations run wild. They apply bold colors to their pictures. Through them, they express their profound love of the sea.
鱼嫂啊，都是闲着嘛。闲着，老早就是打麻将。现在麻将看他，哎，你在画，他在画，大家都赶来，都来学画。
The reporter paints a picture influenced by her brief visit to the island. Mrs. Lin and the other women offer her pointers. They tell the reporter not to limit her imagination and to be bold with her color choices.
我觉得那行啊，这就是反映我们抽象化嘛，那个是吧？你就反映出来了就好了嘛。
我觉得自己心里面怎么样的鱼，怎么样的漂亮，我就怎么样的画，这不一定，这肯定没有这样的鱼是吧？
我这一条鱼是没有眼睛的也可以，反正我想画什么就画什么了。
To others, their paintings are works of art, but to them, these paintings show on a deeper level a hope for a better future. They know very little of any formal painting techniques, but it doesn't matter, as their works come from the heart.
我让他在这里一直笑。来看看我们四个人的作品吧，虽然还没有完成，但已经看得出来，这个是漂亮的海虹，这个是大螃蟹，这个是鱼菇和漂亮的小鱼，还有这个呢是充满想象力的一只大鱼。艺术是源于生活，高于生活的。等过几年再来看你们作品的时候，一定会让我们看到更多的惊喜。谢谢几位，再见。
While in Zhoushan, it's very easy to find yourself by the seaside. The sea has every island in its embrace and provides a livelihood to every islander. It's winter, so many of the women here are spending time mending fishing nets on the beach. As they hop from one island to the next, the sound of fishermen's work songs reverberates in the crew's ears.
Go! 结束了在胜寺几个岛的行程，现在呢，我们要继续乘船前往舟山的另一个县岱山县。
On Dai Shan Island, there are many sculptures of yellow croaker. The islanders have even named their fishing harbor Yellow Croaker Harbor. The yellow croaker is one of the major fish varieties found in Zhoushan. The crew meets Mr. Yu.Who has been engaged in the study of yellow croakers for many years.
Here is the 50米的、60米的、70米的水底的时候，鱼才大王鱼。最多的是下去，下去鱼啊，这个我们就跳起来。
鱼还能跳起来？
哎，我们又跳起来的，还有过过一节的。
Residents of Dai Shan Island who are over 40 years old remember the sound of the yellow croakers from those years. The sound is similar to the croak of a frog, hence the name yellow croakers. Veteran fishermen would crouch in the cabin of their boat to listen for the croaking sound to locate the school of fish.
我是觉得打网也挺高的，价格呢也挺便宜的，对鸡毛钱行。
Unfortunately, overfishing in the past decade has greatly reduced the marine resources in this area, and the number of yellow croakers has been on a steady decline, while their market price has steadily increased. Since his retirement, Mr. Yu has been engaged in the artificial breeding of yellow croaker. Mr. Yu and his colleagues raise the yellow croakers they have caught and release their fry into the sea. The number of fry they release every year is now close to 1 million. Fortunately, this program has started to bear fruit. Mr. Yu takes the crew to the breeding center for a look. The yellow croaker is plump to the touch, and the scales on its head are tinted with a seashell-like luster. Its body is light grey, and its fins are yellow, hence the name yellow croakers. Mr. Yu says that the yellow croaker is treasured by the Chinese, but few people can eat it now because it's simply too expensive. The meat of the yellow croaker is tender and delicious, and the best way to cook it is to stew it with pickled mustard greens. He gives the crew a gift of 3 yellow croakers for them to have a taste of the local flavor. The chef cleans the fish, fries one of them a little, pours water into the pot, and adds ginger slices, salted pickled mustard greens, and some bamboo slices. After the soup begins to boil, the pot is put on a low fire for several minutes until the broth has turned a milky white. The chef then sprinkles some minced spring onion in the pot. The dish is now ready to serve. The chef hasn't added any salt because the pickled mustard greens are salty enough, thus allowing for the fish's unique flavor to shine through. The chef has also braised a yellow croaker in soy sauce and steamed one for the crew to compare.
Oh, very mild, so when I use a knife to chew, it's all broken.
It's
very sweet. Yes, it's very sweet. But mainly, when I eat it, the taste of the noodle sauce 混在里面了，
对对，
新鲜的，然后还有就是雪菜和笋丝，我觉得配的刚刚好。那雪菜有一点嚼劲，然后笋丝也是
脆脆的味道，
脆脆的配上这个鱼肉，它可能比较嫩一点，然后就在嘴里面又有鱼的味道，又有这种雪菜跟笋丝混进去的鲜味儿。
对对对，
难怪你们会这么喜欢这道菜，我觉得这是一个比较原汁原味的吃法。
就是在舟山是比较传统的。
The meat of the yellow croaker in this dish is tender, and there are very few bones. When the fish is cooked with pickled mustard greens and bamboo shoot slices, it has a very special taste. The fish braised in soy sauce and the steamed fish are both very good as well. The residents of Daishan Island are proud of their yellow croakers. They cook the fish in a very simple way, and they hope that they can have a good catch year after year.
在舟山拍摄的这几天，我们穿行于各个岛屿，感受着海洋的无尽魅力。海洋是气候的调节者，是景观的构造者，同时它也是一座丰富的资源宝库。千百年来，生于舟山、长于舟山的海岛居民，世世代代以岛为家，以海为田，在波谷浪峰劳作、耕海牧渔，为人们提供了丰富的海鲜食物，同时也创造了灿烂的海洋文明和海岛风情。 每一个来到舟山的人都会不由自主地爱上海洋，而同时我们也应该感谢海洋，珍惜海洋，善待海洋。沿着美丽的海岸线，远方的家沿海行摄制组在舟山的拍摄还将继续，出发。
海浪洗刷了千年沧桑，才展现你向前的力量。海风吹化了千年的冰霜，才重现你停止的脊梁。多少目光把遥望，你是赤子眷恋的故乡。多少双手把你开创，你是播种梦想的土壤。